round of the Balgoni Motor Company Scottish Sports and Saloons Championship is about to begin. This will wrap up the 2014 season, and it's a brave man that is going to bet against the stunning Aston Martin of Phil Drybra. But it's Stuart White's job in the front-wheel drive ex-touring car alongside. It's going to take a miracle for him to beat the Aston into the first corner. But Charlie Shaw, after his race one drama, has made it to the back of the grid. So let's see, keep an eye on his progress as well. I'm going to hand this one to Richard, and he'll take us through the final race of the year.
Thanks, Joe. Drybra and White on the front row. Warren Dunbar and Paul Bryden, row two, followed by the champion, Andrew Morrison. Finlay Crocker is six. Fiona Kindness, leading Class A1 going into this race. She's seventh from Mark Dawson, then Mark Robson and Chris White. Graham Davidson, Stuart Watts, 12th on the grid, followed by David Gebby, Barry Forbes, Joe Shuttleton, Martin McGeough back again, Ollie Ross, Ross Taylor, David Smale, and Robert Drummond. Then we've got Charlie Shaw, hopefully Alistair Robertson, and Chris Doherty, who we hope could join us. So we are ready for the start of our final race of the year. Lights out! Great start by Drybra, and all the front runners from race one making an absolutely superb start of it. The one driver we didn't get to see in race number one was Martin McGeough, who runs Courier Connections, who very generously sponsored the Clio Cup this year. And it's wonderful to see him. Martin's moved into racing the later stages of the season. If you get to see the Ginetta, it's the ex-Vic Covey Ginetta that ran in the challenge, Ginetta Challenge this year. If you just see it back of shot there, hopefully we'll get a chance to pick it out a little bit later on. But look at Charlie Shaw, he's on a mission from the back of the grid. He started ticking people off already. Well, I know we'd expect that, but it's great to get excited about it. Through, passes the Sayer up front. Of course, we've got the Aston Martin away down the road, and it's one bar running in second position. Then Paul Bryden. Here comes Stuart White, though, in the ex-Tom Christensen car. Used to watch Tom Christensen's dad racing back in the day. He used to race in the, what they call the Jordbana races in Denmark, and was the Danish rallycross and saloon champion back in the day, and sadly passed away earlier this year, Tom's dad, Carl Eric. He was a wonderful, wonderful man. He's got two very, very quick sons. We've got another quick driver here who's emulating his son, Stuart White, who goes through past Warren Dunbar, and he's going to challenge for second position. Paul Bryden there at the moment, Stuart White in the Class A2 car, all over the back of the second place machine at the moment as we watch from the driver's view from Warren Dunbar. Let's see whether Stuart's going to get the job done here. A little bit too far back at the moment, but looks under braking into the hairpin, can't quite do it. This is superb, isn't it, to see this. Oh, Bryden gets a massive tank slapper coming out of the hairpin, and Stuart White read that exceptionally well, reacted superbly. Reactions are what makes a great driver, and White read that so well. Goes through on the inside line, takes second position. Bryden going back to his little mistake there, coming out of the hairpin, collecting it up well. That could have been a lot worse. There's Martin McGeough through the gravel. That causes him to take a spin. The Courier Connections man, the ex-Vic Covey car, a little bit of wheel spin on the grass. Hopefully he'll be able to get out of there, rejoin the race. Wonderful to see a guy who's generously sponsored a championship come into motor racing and enjoying it. And he's quitted himself well in the last few rounds of the Ginetta Challenge. And great to see him up here this weekend taking part in the Balgoni Motor Company Scottish Saloon and Sports Cars. So Stuart White goes out of shot. He's second. Paul Bryden next, then it's Warren Dunbar in the three. This is the last race of the year, and at the moment the positions in the race suggest that Fiona Kindness will win Class A1 by my reckoning, and she's up there challenging Finlay Crocker at the moment in this one, and Fiona makes the pass. So Fiona Kindness goes through, running superbly, but Finlay Crocker's going to repay the compliment. Goes back down the inside. Great move by Crocker in the core cut car. He's not getting too defensive. Racing line through Scotsman corner, coming down into Butchers, up into the Arnold Clark chicane. He's starting to pull away. Kindness, though, looking at thinking Class A1 with Charlie Shaw in Class A1 as well, trying to close up. We've got three starters. I'm thinking championship points here, but however many points are on offer, Fiona is at the moment beating Joe Shuttleton. Joe, I think, is going to wind up as runner-up in Class A1 by my points. And Fiona taking a class crown this year, which is going to be very, very good for Ollie Ross is on his way to the Mazda Cup at the moment. Here we go, in car again. Past Finley Crocker, the power of the 2.3-litre Subaru Impreza really being used to good effect out of the hairpin. Coming down through Duffus, into Leslie's, and then down to Scotsman. Crocker's going to try and come back. We're happening on Mazdas now. David Smale, the yellow Mazda, is the car that we're coming up on. Charlie Shaw making progress and running well. There is Paul Bryden, passes Martin McGeoch. And I'm sure Martin enjoying his racing. And sorry to bang on about the Clios, but he put up a marvellous prize for the Clio Cup this year. It's a fully restored Renault 5 Turbo, which puts a lot of other prize funds to shame, I have to say. So well done to him. Down the straight, though, Charlie Shaw is running well. Charlie Shaw in the 51-second bracket at the moment. The best lap, Phil Driver, lap 3, 51.174 in the Aston. And on lap 6, Charlie Shaw's put a 51.18. So he's only 100th down. So Shaw is taking the battle to Driver. I don't think, given the fact that he had to start at the back of the grid, he's going to be able to get on terms with the Aston race-wise. But certainly in terms of best lap pace, he's really giving it a good shot. And the commentary team here, Gary Stagg, Rob Johnston, Duncan Vincent, all keeping the race fans here at Knockhill appraised of what's going on. And they're looking at those times, and the locals are going to be cheering on the wonderful 2-litre turbo Ford Focus racing for lap times against the 5.7-litre Aston. Blue flags for the back marker traffic. Andrew Morrison goes through. There is Fiona Kindness, the A1, because she's really getting to grips with that machine. And down at Scotsman, we've seen a lot of Martin McGeoch in this one, and we hardly saw him at all in race number one. Had some good airtime here. So through the chicane, you can see Finley Crocker has lost a little bit of ground on Fiona now, and she seems to have got that place settled, as well as her championship title. If she non-finishes this one, it's still a possibility. Then Joe Shuttleton could come through, because he'll pick up 20 points for a second position in class. He's got Charlie Shaw in front of him, as well as Fiona at this stage, as the cars go up the hill once again. So Fiona now trying to close down on Andrew Morrison, this year's champion. And remember, this is a multi-class champion. Got the A-class cars running on the slick racing tyres, and then you've got the B-class cars running on the treaded tyres, and then the A1 four-wheel drive, A2 two-wheel drive for the racing tyres, and then engine sizes determining the B-class cars. And that's where the champions come from this year. And the way that the points are structured by the Scottish Motor Racing Club, who organise things up here at Knockhill Race Circuit, means that you can drive a smaller class car and still come through and win an overall championship, which is great for the fans and great for the competitors. We're on to the last lap, sadly, of 2014 action. But that sadness is balanced by the absolute joy that we've had in seeing this superb entry and the Aston Martin and Phil Driver, who's on his way to taking a second win out of two and a Class A2 win. So Driver leading this one again from Stuart Whyte in the Super Touring Honda Accord. So Driver comes out, a little bit of showboating as well from the Aston, and he comes up and he's going to take the chequered flag. There it is. It's a win for Phil Driver. Two out of two for him here at Knockhill. Driver from Whyte, then Paul Bryden, Warren Dunbar again in A3. Fiona Kindness wins the A1 Championship ahead of Charlie Shaw. Andrew Morrison next, then Alistair Robertson, Mark Dawson, Mark Robson, Chris Whyte and Graham Davidson in the BMW in 12th place. 13th goes to Stuart Watt, Barry Forbes next from David Gebby, then Joe Shuttleton, Martin McGeoch. The Mazda Cup is won by Ollie Ross. Congratulations, Ollie. Ross Taylor next, and David Smale. Phil.